Good morning, everybody. Jeff Carter here in Pattaya. I'm here now, and today we're going on a little boat ride. Yep, we're going to go to KOH LARN, and I'm now at the Bali Hai Pier, and I'm going to try and catch the early ferry this morning. Lots of people going down there already. It looks like it's going to be a lovely day today. So, yep, we're going to make our way down to the boat, and I think it's just 30 baht on the public boat to the island, and then we're going to have a look round and have a great day. The sky's looking lovely and blue, and the sun's just coming up. Looks like it's going to be great. All right then, so let's make our way to the boat. Looking at this lot here, looks like everybody had the same idea. There's about 100 people just walking down the pier now in front of me. But yeah, the boats start at 8 a.m, 9, 11 and 1. KOH LARN 1, 2, all confusing, mainly in Thai. But if you just follow the crowds, I'm sure you'll be all right. Have the correct money ready, because that'll get you on the boat quicker. 30 baht, and away we go. But looking at this lot now, I'll show you it in a minute. There's loads of people in front of me. But it's a lovely place to go. And this harbour's looking fantastic. Now, I'll just show you this. Look how beautiful that is. All the speedboats. But we're going down there. Quickly get past this lot. They're having a bit of a pep talk. So, that'll save some time. And there's only a few more people in front of me, so all good stuff. Oh, just beat them. They're all on the move. It's been years since I've done this, so it's all exciting. I went to bed early last night, woke up early, had a shower, and I thought, right, I'm getting on that first boat. So, and I'm going to go to some different beaches today, or a different beach that I've not been to before. Last time I went to Monkey Beach, but apparently now it's absolutely chock-a-block with people, because everybody knows about it now. So I'm going to have a little walk round and see what we can see. All right, but the boat's just there now, and it's filling up, and it's nearly ready for sailing off. Okay, so KOH LARN, here we come. Well, we're safely on board now, just 30 baht, and the help you're on board, and I think they're ready for sailing now, because the bloke keeps shouting, hurry up, Lulu, quick, we're going. So, yeah, I'll go upstairs, me, and then we can do a little bit of filming. But it's already rocking, and we'll be rolling. All right, I'll see you in a minute. Thank you. Well, folks, we're here. It took about 40 minutes. Bit of a bumpy ride, but it was okay. And yeah, we're here now on the beautiful island of KOH LARN. And it only cost 30 baht to get here. Fantastic. Right, there's a bit of a walkway here. I'm gonna walk around there first and show you that little bit. And then we're gonna go exploring, because I don't know what beach I'm gonna go to yet. So come on, let's have a little look. Wow, look at these waves on the rocks. Right, this looks like it's called Sangwan Beach. There you go. And you just go on this wooden walkway. So it's only early in the morning here now, and I've seen a sign back there. I don't think this lot opens until 11 a.m. in the morning. And I think it's only about, I don't know, about 8:45. But we'll have a little walk through so you can see what it looks like. Some nice racing cars here. And they all double up as seating and tables where you can have your food. And then obviously you've got like a little bit of a restaurant area here. So it looks like it's motor racing theme. And then we walk through even further. And this looks like it's all been made out of bamboo. Very nice. Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome to Thailand.
Yes, yeah, thank welcome. You. Look at this, stunning. Beautiful. And then we've got another restaurant here now. So you can see there's lots to do. And these are little tables, what they'll put all the chairs out soon. And then you've got a beautiful little beach here, what you can sit at when the tide's out. Otherwise, if you sit on them seats now, you're gonna get soaked. So just 40 minutes on a boat away from crazy town, and you've got peace and tranquility. Like I say, don't open till 11 a.m, but when it does, they'll be serving drinks and food, and it'll all be wonderful. And hopefully the tide will have gone out a bit, so you've got a bit more of a beach. And I think we're coming to the end of it now, but I'll just show you the last little bit. Yep, a nice little kitchen here for you. Hello. And then straight onto the beach. There you go. Well, that was a lovely place, wasn't it? Worth a look. Back across the boardwalk now and onto the main beach. But if you're coming to the island, if you come early, you get on them sun lounges, think great. By dinner time, there's about 500 people in front of you, all in the sea, because it's the first beach you come to, you see. But there's a few more beaches on the island, and I'm gonna try and find some of them for you, and see what goes on. All right, so we'll catch you in a bit. Here's the boys bringing the supplies for the day. Just got them off the ship. There you go. Oh, there's loads of them. Some more now. Morning. See, with it being an island, all the food and drinks and all the supplies have to be brought on daily. And then all like the plastic bottles and things, they all have to be removed daily. So it's quite a process, because obviously they've got to have fresh food every day, and it does get busy later, so yeah, all good stuff. As you can see, lovely blue skies, bit of wind, so that's not bad, it'll cool you down a bit. But it looks like I'll do quite a bit of walking today, because I want to go exploring and see what beaches there are. I believe you can get a little motorbike, what you can hire, for not much money. Don't know how much it is yet. But I think I'll just go walking and have a little look round. So we're on the first main beach now. I'm going to walk you down there and show you all the little shops and cafes and things. But at the moment, the tide's in. Normally the tide's out and you can get onto the beach, but there's no beach at the moment. It's hopefully it'll clear soon. So, all right, listen, we could just walk down here now, and I'll just show you what's going on, and then you know. All right. Oh, it's going to be a hot one. It is, I can tell already. Oh, yeah, motorbikes from 200 baht to hire for the day. Just so you can have a little explore around the island. So that's not bad, is it? That's a good deal, that. And as you can see now, here's all the beach loungers. But with them being plastic, they'll just wash away into the sea. So they're up on the concourse right now. But as soon as the tide goes out, which it looks like it is doing now, all these will be on the beach for hire. We are, this girl's shooing the dogs off. Nice lady selling the fruit drinks here. Oh, and this smells gorgeous. I don't know what's cooking here. Smells nice though. Oh, barbecue chicken. Look at that. Wow. It looks as good as it smells. Fantastic. And this looks a nice place. Sugar Sea Beach Club and Restaurant. Look at that. Gorgeous. You can just chill out there for the afternoon in the shade, and they've even got a nice sandy area for you. But that's lovely, that. Fresh fruit and drinks here on the beach. And they've even got golf buggies that you can hire for the island. That'd be fun, wouldn't it? Right then, I was just walking down here and I bumped into my new friend now, Mr. Boone.
Okay.
Now, Mr. Boone rents motorbikes on the island.
For rent.
They're for rent, so you can get to all the beaches, because apparently some of them are far away. So I said, how much? 300 baht for the day, yeah. Okay? Including fuel, which I think is great. And you'll find him here just soon as you walk onto the beach area. Have a look at his face. Remember the man? Remember him?
Yeah.
Mr. Boone, the best motorcycle man on the island.
Okay, thank you.
I'll see you in 5 minutes. I'm just going for a walk down here, Mr. Boone, and I'll come and get a motorbike.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah,
see you later. Yeah, you will. You see me. He won't let me go then. And I said, no, I want to go walking first. Anyway, he showed me the map, and the beaches are quite far away. And I do want to look at them all today so I can tell you which ones are the best. And for 300 baht, it's worth it, innit? All right then, but he does want ID. You don't have to pay a deposit or give your passport in. You just have to show him your ID. But I'm sure you could wangle it if you wanted. All right, I'll just go down here a little bit now, show you the shops, and then I'm getting a motorbike. We're going on one. Come on, beep, beep. And the shops are just selling what they all sell. Just beachwear, t-shirts, flip-flops, etc. Stuff for the kids as well. So, and there's lots of little places where you can plonk down and get some food. All right, so if you're hungry, you can just plonk down and get some food. And we've got some fresh fish here. I think they're seafood. Yep, fresh prawns and crabs. And then we got the chicken. And we got the salted fish. So it's all good stuff, innit, eh? Fantastic mangoes, love them. Fresh mangoes over here are so sweet, it's unbelievable. Lots of restaurants we're coming at now, so all good stuff. So the tide's going out now, so everybody will be back on the beach very, very soon. But it's going to be a lovely day. The boys are there now, getting all the jet skis ready for the day, making sure they're all up and running properly. And then we've got this, the banana boat. Have you ever been on one of them? Ooh, dodgy. Some lovely restaurants here. Look at this one. Beautiful. Let's take a look inside. Look at that. Gorgeous. And I think it's called Banoi. But lovely, look at that. Lady here, selling nice durian fruit. Yeah. Hello, love. And we've got this place now, TC Villa on the beach. Nice little place where you can stay overnight if you wanted to. And we've got a lovely lady here preparing fresh vegetables. Look at that, lovely. Aloy. Whee, happy times. Thank you. And this place is doing Thai green papaya salad. Som tum. Ooh, looks delicious. But how many chilies do you have? I can only have one. They throw about five in, it blows your head off. But it's absolutely wonderful. Yep, so it's 9:20 in the morning now. And hustle and bustle everywhere. Everybody getting ready for the day, you know. To look after the tourists when they get here. There's surfboards, there's jet skis, there's the banana boats, there's all the little restaurants, all setting up ready. It's going to be a long day because I tell you something, them skies are blue. It's going to be a hot one. So it's going to be great. We're going to walk just about another 100 metres and then we're going to go back and see Mr. Boone and get a motorbike off him, because for 300 baht a day, you can see all the island. And if you could ride a motorbike, and there's two here, it's a bargain, isn't it? All right then. So it looks like the tide is well going out now. Loads of people in the sea enjoying themselves already. Well, we've come to the end, so we're going to have a walk back now and save me little legs. We're going to get a little scooter and we're going to find some great beaches for you. All right, stay with me. Hope you're enjoying it. I am. It's lovely, this. I'm just 40 minutes away from Bali Hai Pier in Pattaya, where it's crazy town. Come here and chill out. Have a rest. Lovely island, this. KOH LARN. And here he is waiting for me, Mr. Boone. Yay! Okay, mate, can we have a motorbike?
Yeah.
Yep.
You take like this?
You no, not that one. The other one. Yeah. On the click or something like that.
Over there.
Yep.
Yeah. All in, huh? All in.
Yeah. Well, I've got my motorbike for the day. 300 baht. You can get it a bit cheaper, but I liked him. He's a bit of a character. And he said he's got 10 motorcycles to rent. And I said, have you got a map? He went, no, just go mooching. And that's what you've got to do, haven't you? So you'll just end up going where I end up going. I've never done this before, so it's all brand new to me. It's brand new to you. So stay with me and let's see what we can see, because it all helps out for when you visit KOH LARN. First stop off, the beautiful viewpoint of where all the boats are coming in. I'll just show you now. And just take a look at this for a stunning view. 5 minutes ago we were right down there, and now we're coming up into the mountains. Well, folks, it doesn't get much better than this, does it? This is TM Beach. Okay, so if you're looking for a really nice beach, that's what it's called, TM Beach. All right, and you can either hire a motorbike or get a bat bus. They'll bring you here as well for a small fee. But we're gonna have a little look around now, but it looks absolutely gorgeous. All right, stay with me, because there could be some great surprises just around the corner. Well, it's certainly a lovely beach, absolutely fantastic. Nice and peaceful, nice and relaxed, not many people here, all good stuff. I'm a bit hungry and thirsty now, so not had my breakfast yet, I was up too early. So we'll probably get one of these little restaurant things here now, grab a quick bite to eat. And see what that's like, eh? But this is a lovely island. Right, this looks like a nice little place to eat and have a drink. Hard TN restaurant. I'm just hoping they're serving food. Yep, they're serving food and I've just ordered. I've got myself a nice Coca-Cola. Way. With a glass of ice. Way, hey, hey. And I've ordered sweet and sour chicken. I'll show it you now on the menu. There you go, sweet and sour stir fry with pork or chicken, and it's 180 baht. And with a view like that, what a bargain. Whoops-a-daisy, nearly went all over the place then. Oh, can't wait for this. Nice freezing cold Coca-Cola. Oh, I'm enjoying this island tour, aren't you? This is only stop off one, really. Thank you, sir. Brilliant. Great service here. Nice and cool. Nice cool breeze. Beautiful turquoise ocean. It's like being in heaven. Oh, unbelievable. Can't wait to carry on exploring later. But I'm going to have about an hour here and just chill out because it's idyllic. So if you've never been before, I didn't even know this beach existed. I only ever went to Monkey Beach, but this is miles better. And like I say, you can get a motorbike here. You couldn't walk it here, too far to walk it. You could probably get a speedboat that'll bring you all the way round the island to here. I don't know. But yeah, fantastic so far. It's a thumbs up from me. Wow. I'll show you the food when it gets here, because I'm absolutely Hank Marvin. I'm starving. Whoa, look at that for a view. I'm made up. Take a look at this, folks. This is it. Lots of pineapple and peppers and chicken and a sweet sour sauce. Nice ice cold Coke and a nice portion of white fluffy rice. Wow, that sweet and sour sauce. Amazing. Oh. I'm gonna try this fresh pineapple. Beautiful, and in a beautiful setting as well. This is heaven on earth there. You couldn't beat there. Fantastic. Right, I'll eat this now, and then we'll have a bit of a rest for 5 minutes, I think. Okay, stay with me, because we've got lots more to watch, and I'm going to film a lot more for you today. We're going here, there, and everywhere. All right, catch you in a bit, folks. Beep, beep. Well, you couldn't knock that for the money and the view. Absolutely fantastic. We're going to walk back along the beach now and see where we go next. The beach is filling up here now as well. So it's quite a busy day today all over the island. But it is a gorgeous day. So, yeah, why not? Enjoy yourself. There's hundreds of people in the sea all enjoying themselves. Wow. But I've only got a few more hours left, so I've got to jump back on the motorbike now and find the next beach for you. But I think I'll come here again without the cameras and just plonk myself down here for the day and get a nice tan. It's absolutely gorgeous. Everybody just checking in the summer breeze. Right, folks, time to say goodbye to this beautiful place, and we're on to the next beach now, so back on the bike and we'll see you at the next beach. Right, we've just arrived at the next beach and it's called Samay Beach. So let's just check it out. Looks very nice. Nice white sand. And a nice calm sea. Lovely. Well, this beach is really crowded, lots and lots of people. So this is a busy beach, this one. All right, let's get back on the bike. We're going to search for the next beach. Just pulled over because I've seen this wonderful place and I've got to just show it you. It's called the Lobby KOH LARN Bistro and Bar. Have a look at this. It's made like a big boat and it's beautiful. How nice is this in the middle of nowhere? Wow. I'm really enjoying today, and I hope you are too. So stay with me. There's loads more to come yet. Don't go anywhere. The aliens have landed. The aliens have landed. Look at that. Right, folks, after a long road there then, we've just pulled up here, and I've just asked one of the drivers, is this Monkey Beach? And he went, yeah, it's changed since I've been and it's absolutely ramp. He says falling over that rope. Nah, nearly went then, didn't I? Whoopsie then. Anyway, yeah, it's ram jam full here now. So this is one of them places that just got too over advertised, because when we first come here there weren't many people here, but there's speedboat after speedboat, there's bat buses pulling up, loads of motorbikes. I'll just quickly show it you, but if you want a restful, peaceful beach, I'd go to that TN, because this just looks very, very commercialized now and very, very full. But let's have a look. But I'll just walk onto the seafront now and just show it you. Not much of a beach. It's all sun loungers and umbrellas, and then probably a couple of meters of sand. So, but it's a nice place. Got loads of people. I'll just show it you now. Chock-a-block, too busy for me there. Like you say, if you don't want them sun loungers, you're not sunbathing. You're in the shade. So down there, there's probably a little bit of sunbathing area, but it's called Monkey Beach, and there's not a monkey in sight. There's loads of little dogs, but not many monkeys. Right, let's go and see if there's any more beaches, and then it's time to relax. Stay with me. There could be some hidden gem just round the corner. I just saw this little alleyway, so I pulled over and started walking down, thinking it was a restaurant at the end, but a woman ran up and she went, "No, it's an hotel." I said, "Can you buy food here?" She went, "No." I said, "Can I just take a little video?" She went, "Okay." So I'm just going to show you this beautiful view if you stayed in this hotel. Look at this for a lovely view. Unfortunately, it's residents only, so if you stay here, I presume you can get some food out there, but I'm getting hungry now, so it's a case of getting back on the bike over the island again and get some food. All right. Oh well, folks, I'm back to square one where we started from, and I tell you something, on the other side of the island the sea is so calm, it's unbelievable. But on this side of the island where you first come in, the beach is absolutely ram-jam full now of people, and the waves, wow, I'll show it you now. The sea's really rough on this side today, but if you come right to the end of all the shops and carry on down there behind me, round that corner there, there's another beach, and it's even nicer, and there's not many people there because obviously they think, oh, that's the end of it. But if you walk around there about a quarter of a mile, there's another nice little cove with beach and restaurants and places to eat and things. So that's worth going. If it's too full here and you don't want to go up on the motorbikes or the back buses over the mountains, if you come right down here behind me, there's an hidden secret. It's just around the corner and it's really nice and really tranquil. So there's a little bit of info for you. But I'll just show you the sea now. You know, it's rough, I'll just give you that. It's absolute bedlam here. Come to get away from it all. Yeah, check this out. There's just hundreds and hundreds of people. Not exactly my idea of fun, that lot. Can't move there. Room, room. So basically you've got to get across to one of the other beaches really, because this is the first port of call, and they all just come here. And you just seen it then. It's bedlam. And all you've got is jet skis and boats revving up. You know, and on the other side of the island, it's nice and quiet, you know. And I don't think it'll cost you much in a back bus just to go to one of the other beaches. So, yeah, I'm going to take the motorbike back now because I've shown you around the island really, and I want to give it back to Mr. Boone, and then he can rent it out again, can't he? You know, it's all about helping out. And then catch that early boat back, because apparently my friends have just told me before. I said, "What time's that last boat?" He said, "You better get there early." He said, "Because last night it pulled off really early and some people got stuck on the island." How about that then? So yeah, I'm going to head back now. So I'll take the bike back and then get myself sorted. All right, keep watching, it's not over yet. Well, you wouldn't believe it, I just missed that last ferry back on the other side. by about 5 minutes. It was just pulling off as I got there. So Mr. Boone kindly said to me, get on the back of my motorbike and I'll take you to the other pier where the sea's much calmer and there'll be a boat leaving soon. And I think there is. So we've done well. Thanks, Mr. Boone, if you're watching. Nice one, mate. This'll do us. There you go. Should be pulling off soon. Well, we're on board now, and I just asked the lady, I said, what time are we setting off? She said, in about 35 minutes. So it's best just to get on board and just settle down, and then at least you know you're not going to miss the boat, are you? They run every hour from both piers, but that other pier just, it was so rough, the boats were giving it that. And on this side of the island, it's nice and calm. So yeah, we'll be setting off, and then on our way back to Crazy Town. Then what's going to happen, we don't know, do we? Alright, so keep watching. I'll film a bit of the journey back, and then we'll say goodbye on the video. Alright, see you in a bit. Well, that was a fantastic little day out, and if you're in Pattaya or John TM on a Clua, just come down to Bali Hai Pier, get on an early morning. You've got to come early morning, get on an early morning boat, and it's only 30 baht and it takes you all the way to the island. We've seen some great beaches today. It's been a wowzer. I've had a little rev round on the motorbike. It's been a really enjoyable day, so I hope you've all enjoyed it as well. Don't forget, there's more movies coming soon, and the only way you're going to see them is if you subscribe and hit the little bell, because we love it when you do that. Leave us some comments, give us a thumbs up or a thumbs down, and you know what I'm going to say now. And the main thing is, keep smiling!